The Wuhan Institute of Virology. If you follow this show, you must be familiar with this name. It keeps coming up in our reports in different ways. China calls it the largest virus bank in Asia. America calls it the birthplace of the Wuhan virus. The same lab is back in the headlines for a secret deal between China and Pakistan, and that's our cover story tonight. An agreement to build bio-warfare capabilities, bio-weapons. This is the deal between China and Pakistan, and the Wuhan Institute of Virology is right at the center of these claims. Australian journalist Anthony Clann reported this story first. He is the editor of a news website called The Klaxon. His story talks about a deal, a three-year agreement signed between Pakistan's Defense Science and Technology Organization and China's Wuhan Institute of Virology. On the face of it, this is just a research collaboration, an alliance to research what they call emerging infectious diseases. But according to Anthony Clann, this alliance has a more sinister agenda. This program is being entirely funded by China, and that's no surprise. The country of Pakistan, we know, is largely funded by China. But this deal allows China to conduct tests on biological agents outside its borders in Pakistan. According to the report, this is a covert deal hidden from the world. There's a secret facility in Pakistan. It runs several research projects related to deadly pathogens. Pathogens like anthrax, which has been used as a bioweapon in the past. Now, earlier today, we spoke to Anthony Clann, the journalist who first reported this story, and we began by asking him about the specifics of this covert agreement.
Pakistan has... To get to the number of it, Pakistan has organized, along with China, to set up, what could be biological warfare components or a factory for biological warfare in Pakistan, completely funded by China. Now, clearly, it would appear that intelligence agencies have quite a big concern about this, given the nature of the animosity currently, particularly between China and India. So this particular outfit is a laboratory, and it's been set up, allegedly been set up by the Wuhan laboratory, the infamous, now infamous Wuhan laboratory, in order to develop pathogens which could be used for nefarious purposes.
Why should India care about any of this? Because it poses a direct security challenge for India. According to the report, Pakistan has kept civilians out of this project. I mentioned the Defense Science and Technology Organization of Pakistan before. This is a military agency. It comes directly under the Pakistani army, like everything else in Pakistan, you could say. But this is strictly military. And it works on science and technology projects, innovations that are marked for military use. Anthony Clann says that New Delhi must pay attention to this threat.
The purpose it achieves, there are a couple of purposes. One of the purposes, allegedly, is that it permits China to test biological agents off its own soil. So if something were to go wrong, it would not be on China's soil, it'd be in Pakistan's soil. And there are claims that this has been happening for some time. And that's one component. Secondly, it also brings Pakistan closer to China. It's a tie-up, it's a military tie-up between these two countries, and particularly right on the border with India, that poses quite a bit of concern. So between the capability and the threat, I think that those two factors combined are raising pretty serious concerns.
Well, here's a question. If this is just another research project, why should China and Pakistan keep it a secret? What's there to hide? They're hiding it because the intentions are the opposite of noble. Creating a covert research facility allows China to conduct dangerous experiments out of the public view. So when the facility is on foreign land, and that too in a Chinese colony like Pakistan, China can evade responsibility when something goes wrong. They've learned their lesson from the Wuhan virus. What's in it for Pakistan? Why is it playing host? Because it gets access to bioweapons. The mutual agreement means Pakistan's army could be armed with dangerous pathogens. And this is a major security threat, not just for India, but for the world. Let me explain why. These pathogens are being tested in labs that have a lower safety level. In science, biosafety level 4 is considered as the highest level of biosafety precautions. Fatal diseases that can easily transmit should be tested only in biosafety 4 facilities, which have the level 4. The Wuhan Institute of Virology has biosafety level 4, and yet there were questions about safety. There were questions about the standards being followed there. What's the chance that a Pakistani facility can do better? Very low. Reports say Pakistan is carrying out this research in labs that are not equipped to handle dangerous viruses. China is building another virus bank in Pakistan, but without the necessary precautions. One way or the other, it's a disaster waiting to happen. If they make a bioweapon, it's a threat to the world. If a safety breach happens, it's a threat to the world. China and Pakistan, threat to the world.